Hello.
Hello.
Hello. So Master Yu Dan Qiu has taken us up to the Crane Temple, which is on a hill just outside of Fuzhou City. And it's in this temple where Minghe Quan, or Crying Crane, which is a style he practices, was founded.
It's a story here, story of this temple. He say something about his connect with the karate, Goju
Ryu. Goju Ryu.
Goju Ryu here. Goju Ryu.
Oh, Goju Ryu.
Goju Ryu. Zhu Ting means 就是发源地，它的祖宗的，它是源头。
So the founder of Goju Ryu learned crane style in this temple.
Zhu Ting is like 源头. Yes. It's about it built about Han Dynasty.
This temple was built.
So this temple was built in the Tang Dynasty. So about 600-700 AD.
Yeah.
Obviously, is this not the original building anymore?
No,
but...
no.
He Chao Si, so it's the Crane's Nest Temple. So it's been renovated heavily, but the layout of it is based on the original Tang Dynasty design. Yeah, because you can see it's a lot more simple looking than a lot of the newer temples.
Okay.
So normally you shouldn't really film inside Buddhist shrines, but we've been told that we're allowed to, so I'll just show you. Along the side you've got the 18 Luohan along either side, so the Luohan are like really, really important in figures in Chinese martial arts. They're like the early, I guess, like the early disciples of Buddha, or some people that attained enlightenment quite early on. And then here at the side, here you've got Damo or Bodhidharma, the sort of mythical founder of Shaolin Kung Fu.
There's no picture of a crane.
In the middle is the Buddha, and these are the other Luohan behind me. And this person here is a Taoist god, because I said this temple is Taoist and Buddhist together. So this person here is the White Crane spirit. So he's supposed to be the spiritual ancestor of Crane style. The myth goes that Fang Qinyang, the lady that created Crane style, that she got divine inspiration from this god here.
So Yong Chun.
Yong Chun.
Yong Chun.
Yeah.
It's like forever.
Oh, Yong Chun. It's not Chun. Not Yong Chun the Chun. Oh, look. Can you see the crane?
Wow.
On the stone. So this is.
它是还原了一些过去，就是更真实。它是有过去那个一千多年，然后。
Oh, so there was a crane. This is redone in concrete, but for a thousand years there was a crane on here, but it was smashed off in the Cultural Revolution. Yeah. So the stone's been here for 1,000 years.
A pig.
A lion. Oh, this also a 1,000-year-old lion that was destroyed in the Cultural Revolution, so they've tried to redo it with concrete.
And it became a pig.
Yeah.
有点像猪.
Yeah, it does. They just did it themselves, that's why they just tried to fix it up themselves. So she's trying to renovate this place herself. Oh, so there's like a cave. They found that there's an old cave underneath this place, which is where they used to like go into retreat to meditate or something. So this nun was telling us the reason this is called the Crane's Nest Temple is because there's these two rocks, one at either side, the one that I showed you at the other side and then this one. So that one was male and this one's female, and then it's the two cranes that made their nest here, and then the temple was built around that. But as you can see, they were destroyed in the Cultural Revolution, so they've tried to fix them up themselves using concrete, but it's quite rough looking. So, as this is the Crane's Nest Temple, the ancestral home of Minghe Quan, and also apparently it's the place where the founder of Goju Ryu Karate also came to learn. So Jesse, in his seeking out the roots of karate, is now going to learn the first form of Minghe Quan here at the place where it was created. How are you feeling, Jesse? To learn Minghe Quan in the place where it was founded.
I'm excited.
You ready?
<音><音><音><音><音><音><音><音><音>
So you're curling your tongue inside, clenching your teeth, and what he was saying was when somebody comes to get you in a headlock, it's not that the neck, it's not that the tensing the neck is resisting the headlock, it's that this position pushes your chin down, so your chin gets in the way, so they can't lock you. And then you can, because your chin's quite strong, so you can use the force of your chin as you're turning your body to counter it.
所以一定要按一下子过来，抬手啪，很快，不要说锁住的，那就没话说。Can
you read that?
Yeah, I can read. Actually, I have one. The golf. In my dojo.
Ah, nice.
The small one.
五倍字。
这些是老的书吗？
老的书，这是一部分，有关的药。
这边的药三是另外的，不在这个书，这个是专门是武术的。他这个五辈子有这五辈子的，这是日本的还是我们？这日本的，这个书另外不在这里，不在这个药。
是在另外，
另外有书。
So there's several books, right? And the medicine and stuff is not in these ones that he's got here. They're in some other books. It's like
a big collection of
books.
这是专门是武术的，药不在里面。
These ones are only about the martial arts.
药不在里面。那他们是哪一年写的？ 这很久了，我是父亲从那个时候是。
So his father copied the hand copied these from the originals.
破掉了。那在文革的时候没有被烧掉吗？藏起来了，应该是。藏起来了。
So they had to.
这个药。It's
the medicine one.
破了。啊，这个是被烧了。这不是文化大革命。The
Cultural Revolution, all the books were burnt.
烧掉了我。
So when they tried to burn the book, he saved them, basically.
Wow. That's why it's kind of burned on the edges.
这个都是以前的，这都是药。
Yeah, look, there you go, that's the...
烧文化大革命，知道文化大革命，烧掉，烧这个书烧掉了，我的小孩子，哎呀，你说的人，但你敢吗？你不怕你这样去？我很小。
我就偷了，我跑走了。 so he secretly, he was a little kid, and he like took it out the fire, like he snuck off with it. So I mean,
剩下都烧掉了，所以我父亲呢把这个老的书他重新再写出来了。这个就是原来的五倍。
这些是文革后父亲写的，抄的，但是旧的书跟这个一样。 okay, so these ones, this one's like from before the revolution, right? And saved from burning. These ones, his father hand wrote them after the revolution. He copied them from the original ones that were damaged.
烧掉了，你看，没了，他赶紧抄下来。
这个马卡提，this is the translation.
有好多本。